Compost. Hi, I'm Jamie.
Hey, I'm Monique.
And we're Compostable LA.
That went really well.
And we're Compostable LA. So I just want to let everybody know that we're both fully vaccinated. We both got a COVID test and we're social distancing.
Compostable LA was founded in 2019 by me because there was really a lack of composting resources here in Los Angeles. And so I just saw a need in my community that I decided to fill.
Yeah, and I was just hustling. Let me explain how it works, super simple. Basically, you get this bucket, you put your food scraps in the bucket, and then you put the top on, you leave it outside, we come by, we pick it up, and then we leave you a new bucket. It's really that simple.
So when you get your bin, you can put anything that was grown from the earth, your carrot tops, your coffee grounds, your eggshells. The things that you don't want to put in here are things like produce stickers, staples, rubber bands, anything that's non-organic. In our bins, we even take meat and dairy and citrus, but some other bins can't handle that. So after we pick up the compost from your house, what we're gonna do is bring it to an urban farm here in Los Angeles, and then our nonprofit partners, LA Compost, take over from there. What they do is create almost like a lasagna out of your food waste. So they're gonna do a layer of green materials, which is your food waste, and then a layer of brown materials, which is anything that's carbon-based, like mulch or sawdust. So once they're done layering, for 2 months, that pile will sit and all this microbial activity will take place, really heating things up. The mix of that heat and the microbials eating your food waste is really what breaks everything down. It then moves into what we call a curing phase, where a whole different set of microbes move in and really finish that process to create that beautiful compost material you can add to your garden.
So twice a year, Compostable LA actually has farm days where they invite members to come and actually come to the farm where the compost is being created, and you can take some of that compost home with you so that you can put it in your own garden and grow your own food, which hopefully then you're going to put in your bucket and return to us. It's really important to be able to close the loop. I think that's what kind of makes this really nice, is that you can see it from start to finish, really literally. Actually, I learned a couple years ago that the smell and hormone that's released is the same one that's released when mothers give birth, which is really sweet. Then you can actually bring it and put it right into your garden as an additive into your soil. And that's gonna be the food that the plants are gonna use to make the food that we eat, which is really cool. I mean, it's food. People love food. I love food. I hope everybody else loves food. And if you don't, are you dead? Ooh, womp womp.
That's a long one.
Side
effects of composting may include decreased levels of methane, increased water filtration, soil regeneration, less landfill reliance,
stormwater pollution filtration, reduction in soil erosion, carbon sequestration, stress reduction on the power grid,
higher nutrient content in food, increased plant production, food sovereignty, less nutrient leaching, decreased reliance on chemical fertilizers, community empowerment.
And did I mention a happy planet?
If you want to learn more, check us out at compostablela.com, and we hope you start composting today, whether that's at home or using a service. You can see a whole list of services at litterlist.com, so maybe there's one in your area.